Man, it's been a long time since I've seen some good disaster porn. Hey guys, this is Alachi, and this is my review for Deepwater Horizon. This is a movie starring Mark Wahlberg, Kate Hudson, Kurt Russell, John Malkovich, and newcomer Gina Rodriguez. It is written by Matthew Michael Carnahan, the screenplay writer for State of Play, and Matthew Sand, the screenplay writer for Ninja Assassin, and directed by Peter Berg, who also directed Mark Wahlberg in Lone Survivor. This film is based on the infamous real-life events of the Deepwater Horizon oil rig, which occurred on April 10th, 2010. So if you're not familiar with that infamous story, then everything else I will be saying will be huge spoilers, so just a warning about that. But it was so infamous that I don't know how anyone doesn't know about this. All right, so here I go into the kind of overview of the events. So the oil rig does explode on this day, and that is exactly when this story starts to take place. What it does a very interesting job of doing is kind of giving you back the human element of the story. When tragic disasters like this happen, what tends to come out of it are numbers, you know, number of casualties, number of X, Y, and Z, but never the human stories and the kind of humanity of a tragedy. This story tries to bring back the humanity into what actually happens when something like this goes down, what the individual consequences are of something like this, to show you in great detail what it would be like to be on this oil rig during this event. And so it starts off with Mark Wahlberg, who plays Mike Williams, an engineer who works for Transocean, and also Mr. Jimmy, played by Kurt Russell, who is also a Transocean. I think he's kind of like a project manager, installation manager, and he's kind of really in charge of the safety on board the rig. And it kind of shows them getting ready, especially Mike's character, who is talking with his daughter, and she's getting ready to do a school project, which she's explaining to her classroom and her classmates what her father does for a living. I thought they did a really good job here of a kind of foreshadowing of events, but also an explanation as to how oil wells work and what it's like, what kind of pressure is formed in these oil wells, what the people on the rigs actually do. Because, you know, the way that I always thought about the subject, or how I thought that these oil rigs worked, was that they were actually pumping oil out, but they're not. All they're doing is they're finding the oil, they're trying to drill into the oil well, and then they try to plug in the seal. And she does this amazing demonstration with this little tiny Coke can, you know, kind of like a science fair sort of project. And I just was like, ah, that's so simple and so well done, and sort of just explains to anybody who's just not really familiar with oil wells kind of how all this stuff works. And I just thought that that kind of simplicity was really nice. And this the whole kind of movie is very simplistic. It doesn't try to oversell things. It doesn't try to make a giant hero story. It doesn't try to make any things too complex. It is just the simplicity of the events leading up to and into the actual tragedy. And of course, so once they get to the rig, you can kind of tell things are kind of going awry. Like, the first thing that they see is that the people who are supposed to be testing the cement are leaving, and they're just like, hey, what's going on? And you can kind of tell you're building up. You see, like, you know, the steps coming all into place, and they do a couple of tests, and you see a bunch of knobs turn. And I'm not really sure what all the pressure tests mean or what they actually represent. But they do kind of give you a very simplistic kind of dumbed down version of, like, you can see what numbers equals good, what numbers equals bad, how much PSI we're talking about. And then it gives you really good foreshadowing as to what's coming. Now, once the actual explosion happens, or actually, I guess it's called a blowback or whatever, where, you know, you can tell there's some sort of pressure issue going on and something's about to go really bad. Once that starts to happen, the entire movie takes on a whole different animal. And I'm talking about a sheer beast of an animal. And it is impressive. I mean, you feel it. It is the type of powerful disaster that you expect in movies like this, where it hits you to your core and you just feel the sheer strength of something that powerful. And that's what I thought this movie did so, so well at. I mean, despite the fact there's really not much character development going on, there's not much to the story itself, but just the demonstration of what is happening is so well done. The set design that they created, I mean, how many pounds of metal they used, I don't even know. But I could not distinguish, the visual effects are so good, I could not distinguish the difference between them being on an oil rig in the Gulf of Mexico and then being on a fake set next to Six Flags in New Orleans. I mean, that is, I didn't even know. I really thought they filmed all this on an actual ocean water on an oil rig. I mean, that's how real it felt. It felt gritty, it felt dark, it felt dirty, it felt metal. It just felt so powerfully real that I felt like I was in that situation. Are there a couple of like big blockbuster type moments? Yes, it is definitely full of like tense explosive power and, you know, a couple of moments where you're just like, I'm not really buying that this could happen. But overall, I just think it was so impressive and I kind of can't wait to get it on Blu-ray or even, I even thought about maybe going to watch it again, just because once you get to the point where this movie really has an impact, it blows you away. So I'm going to give Deepwater Horizon a B+. I just really recommend this as a great movie to go see. It should have been a summer movie, I think. And it's so weird, kind of, I feel wrong sort of saying that there's an awesomeness to the tragedy that they're showing, but it is, it really is. And they do a good job of doing it to show you like how powerful an event like this would be to a human being. And that's just, it's so impressive. All right, guys, I actually do have a t-shirt giveaway. It is, well, if you're in the north, I suppose you're kind of getting ready for fall weather, so this might apply. Here in the south, we've got another 2 months or so before we experience anything cool, but this is a long sleeve Star Wars shirt. This is a men's size small, and it's got, you know, a lot of cool stuff on it, and it's got stuff on the sleeve as well. What does it say on the sleeve? It says, Dark Side. Oh, nice. Yeah, I like that. And then on the other side, I think it's just a little gun. Yep. So all you have to do to enter the t-shirt giveaway is be a subscriber and like this video and tell me how much would someone have to pay you to work on an oil rig for a year at 2 weeks to 3 weeks at a time? I actually had this discussion with my best friend, so now I'm kind of curious to ask you guys. And if you're not interested in the giveaway, you can also answer the question as well. And if you're just interested in the giveaway, you can just maybe mention that you're also interested in the shirt so I know. All right, guys, thanks for watching. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my Yoga Hosers review, or you can click right here and watch my Hell or High Water review. Until next time, see you on the flip side.